Hi, this is Matthew Stout from the CCDC. Today, I would like to show you how to use ConQuest to search complex metal organic framework fragments. Let's get started. First, we will open ConQuest using the desktop icon. Then, we're going to load the metal organic framework subset. To do this, we'll click View Databases from the top level menu, List in CSD version 5.42, and MOF subset. This will take a minute to load, however, when it does, it will give you a hit list of all the metal organic frameworks within the CSD. This list can be seen on the right hand side of the screen here, and should you wish to visualize them as a 3D visualizer, you can click on the tab on the left hand side here. However, our structure of interest today is ABOHOO. In order to look for this, you can either scroll down the list on the right, or you can type in the window above ABOHOO. You can see three components here. However, we are interested in basing our search on the dipyridylammonium ligand, so we just want to separate out these components. In order to separate them out, we can tick Users Query, and we can tick Make each chemical unit a separate query. I'm going to untick Include hydrogen atoms as well. Then tick OK, and it will create three separate queries, each for each of the components. The one we're interested in is this with the cobalt center, so we're going to tick Edit. Initially, we would only like one of these dipyridylammonium ligands to be included in our search, so we'll erase the other one. I'll erase it by clicking Erase and ticking each of the atoms in turn to erase the ligand. Secondly, we would like to broaden our search to any first row transition metal as a core of any charge. To do this, we will start by clicking on More, Other Elements, and 1R. And this will mean that any first row transition metal will be selected. We'll then tick OK, and click on the cobalt center, change it to any first row transition metal represented by 1R. We can change the charge to unspecified by right-clicking Charge and clicking Unspecified. Finally, we would like to change one of these oxygens to any halogen. To do this, we will click More, Any Halogen, click on one of the oxygens, which will change it to 7A, which represents any halogen. Now that we've done this, we would like to know the distance between the centroids of each of these two rings. First, we will click Add 3D, and we will find the centroids of the rings. We will do this by clicking on each of the atoms in turn within one of the rings. I will start with the N2 ring. So we'll click on all six atoms here. Once we've done this, in the geometric parameters window, we'll click centroid, define. This defines the centroid of this ring as cent1. We will then do the same for the second ring, and then define the centroid, and this one will be called cent2. Because we would like to know the distance between cent1 and cent2, we can click on cent1, cent2. Under valid parameters, there's distance, and we can click define. That's also come up in the 3D parameters on the top right hand side. Once we're happy, we will click Done. Now that our search is prepared, we will just click Search in the bottom right. We do not want to overwrite existing queries, so we will click No. We'd like all 3D coordinates determined for all of our search. We could tick only organometallics, however, they will all be organometallic anyway. Now we're happy, we will click Start Search. This will return a list of hits which all meet the criteria underlined in the previous step. On the top right hand corner, you can see the distance between the centroids as dist1. Finally, we would like to analyse this data and tabulate all of the distance between the centroids for each of these ref codes. To do this, we will use Mercury's data analysis module. We'll do this by clicking File, Analyse Data in Mercury, and as we're happy with our default components, ticking Analyse in Mercury. The Mercury window will then appear. Your tabulated data may be hidden behind the 3D visualizer, so it's back here for me. If you'd like to make a plot of all of the distance between these centroids, you can click Plot, Histogram, and change the histogram to dist1. You'll create a histogram of all the distances between each of the centroids of your hit list. You should now be able to use ConQuest to search complex metal organic framework fragments. Thank you very much for watching.